guys, what is going on? I hope you all had a fantastic week. I certainly had. And today I want to respond to the Goatfathers Moto Talk episode number 3. The topic for this week was getting into motorcycles for the right or wrong reason. I want to start by telling you why I got into motorcycles. I already told you how I got into motorcycles. If you haven't seen this video, there will be an annotation on your screen. And so, why did I get into motorcycles? Well, I was looking for a new experience. And as I told you, I was in London and motorcycles looked like lots of fun. And I remembered that as a kid I already spent hours looking at motorcycles. So I checked out videos on YouTube and I started to dream about motorcycles. So I was looking for a new experience and maybe a little bit for an adrenaline kick. A rush, because I love adrenaline, and motorcycles are a great way to get this kick. Let's talk about why you shouldn't get into motorcycles. You shouldn't get into motorcycles just to look cool, because yeah, you will look cool, but please don't try to look cool on a motorcycle, because if you try to look cool on a motorcycle, you're going to kill yourself. This is for sure, brother. You also shouldn't get into motorcycles to impress the opposite sex. It probably will work, because let's admit it, bikes are damn sexy and riders are sexy as hell, but there are cheaper ways to do it. Just go to a bar and try to impress the girl, because, you know, it's only the first impression. And let's be honest, bikes are very expensive first impression. So don't do it for the opposite sex. You also shouldn't get into street bikes if you want to become the next Marc Marquez or Valentino Rossi, because road bikes and roads are not meant for those kind of riding styles. You can do it, but it's not safe, and you really shouldn't do it. Another thing I really often hear is that people get into motorcycles for commuting and that they think commuting on a bike will be way cheaper for them. I don't believe that. If you have a 600cc bike, you will consume about 6 or 7 liters per 100 kilometers on gas, and every 10,000 kilometers you will need some new tires. So I can't see how this is cheaper than a simple car, you know? Of course, if you want to get the same performance per buck as you get with a motorbike, you can't beat a motorbike or motorcycle. They are just the best offer there is for the buck. So now that I have covered the right and wrong reasons for getting into motorcycles, let's talk about how those reasons have changed for me over the time. At the beginning, as I told you, I just was looking for a hobby that gives me an adrenaline rush. But now, riding has become a lifestyle. It's amazing. For one point is that when you're out, you're so connected to your surroundings. To the air, to the smells, to the wind. It's fucking amazing. Another reason I love riding so much is the amazing community. I have met so many new people and they are all amazing. We all share the same hobby and we instantly have a topic to cover when we meet. That was a little bit close. And the people are just amazing. And the third point is still the adrenaline rush. It still gives me a kick when I'm out riding. And there's a fourth reason why motorcycles are amazing, because it's a skill you can master. Every time you ride, you are getting better. And it's a skill that needs so much work, but it also rewards you with so much. So, an awesome hobby. So these are my thoughts on getting into motorcycles for the ride and the wrong reasons, and how those reasons have changed for me over time. As always, check out the Goldfather, and I hope you will have another great week, and I see you in my next video. Bye bye. Although right now I'm only making a few cents with every video I put out, I have a dream. Let's start with a little background information. I come from a big family. I have four siblings. So in my opinion, speeding in the city is really dangerous. You shouldn't do it, but I'm guilty of it too, so don't take me for an example.